In this video, we're going to talk about spill kits. What are they, how they work, and everything you need to know when it comes to environmental management. G'day Brett, nice to talk to you. So talk to me about spill kits, the good, the bad, the ugly.
Certainly. Okay, spill kits, there's two main types. There's a hydrocarbon and a hazcam spill kit. Mm-hmm. Hydrocarbon's for your oils and your fuels. Hazcam is for your chemicals, your acids and caustics. Now, spill kits are used to clean up spills. So from workshops to very large situations. So a spill kit is a necessary piece of gear in any sort of workshop, industry, or general, and anywhere that can be a spill.
Okay, and when you say necessary, you're not just talking about it from a moral point of view environmentally, but it's legislated as well.
Absolutely. Okay, there's the moral side of it. You know, we want to look after the environment, but yeah, you've got to keep a spill on site. If a spill gets into a drain and gets off site, the EPA gets involved, there's large fines.
Gets nasty very quickly.
It gets nasty, so we should all have spill kits.
So from the small to the large, what are the sorts of things that are in a spill kit?
Okay, in a normal spill kit, you'll have pads, which are in a hydrocarbon pad. They'll absorb hydrocarbons and repel waters. Mm-hmm. In a hazcam kit, they'll absorb acids, caustics. You also have floor sweeps. There's a couple of different types of floor sweeps, but mainly the one we use can bioremediate soils. So if you have a spill on the soil, it'll bioremediate it with the use of microbes.
If someone's buying a spill kit for the first time, what are some of the things to look out for that you should definitely have? And is there anything to avoid?
Okay, in a spill kit, it should be mobile. So usually a Sulu bin's a great idea. It's a good size and you can wheel it to the spill site.
So the classic wheelie bin?
The classic wheelie bin is ideal for the spill kits, yes.
Okay, cool. Are there some that you can even pick up? I imagine there's small ones you can just pick up in a case.
There's a vehicle kit that can go into your car. So if you do have a spill, if you get a hole in your fuel tank, there's a spill kit that you can grab and you can contain the spill, make sure it doesn't get to waterways until you get help.
Okay, good. So we're talking about spills here, by the way. I imagine oil, fuel, what sort of other things can a spill kit deal with?
It can deal with chemicals. As I said, the hazcam spill kit will deal with chemicals, right up to acid and caustics. The main difference in a hydrocarbon and a hazcam kit is the PPE.
And sorry, what does PPE stand for?
Personal protective equipment.
Okay, so clothing.
So you've got to look after yourself as well as the environment, yes.
Okay, let's talk about how to use spill kits. Let's say something unfolds. Of course, you're going to have to be trained in this, but what are the sorts of things that you need to do?
Most importantly, contain and make sure you can clean it up yourself. If it's a small spill, you can contain it, then you can look after it. So after you've done the containment, then you can do the cleanup. You can take your time. You use the pads and the floor sweep.
Okay.
Containment is key. Make sure it doesn't get into your waterways, into your drains.
And quite quickly too, you've got a sort of a matter of minutes in some cases.
Absolutely, so your workforce should be trained and they should know the products and you should have the equipment very close to where a spill could occur.
Okay, good. Anything else that's critical about spill kits that we should know?
Yeah, make sure you've got it, make sure it's full.
Right, you don't want to open it and find at the moment
absolutely
that it's empty, that all the bits you need are gone.
Yes, yeah.
Now that's good advice, appreciate that. For those of you who'd like to find out more, please visit us online at bulbeckenviro.com.au. Send us an email, give us a call, we'd be more than happy to help.